Hello, my name is Tonkadal. I'm a software engineer at Microsoft for over 15 years, and I have over 25 years of industry experience. I do several technical interviews and hiring decisions in day-to-day basis. And in this video, I'm trying to educate people few things that are important to understand before preparing or going for an interview. Few things that I'll cover on these videos are, number one, what type of technical jobs do companies like Microsoft offer? Number two, what are the natures of these jobs and what are differences? Number three, how should you prepare for these jobs? Number four, are there any resources available on the web? Number five, when solving problems, what you should really focus on? And there are many more. Please watch the full video. Now, let's see types of jobs that big companies offer. Generally, there are three broad categories of jobs. First is test, or popularly known as SDET, or QA, or tester. Second type of job is dev, or popularly also known as developer, or SWE or SDE. Third type of job is PM. The full form is program manager. They are not really people manager, but project managers. Program manager, as I said, they generally are non-technical position, but you must have fair amount of technical knowledge to get these type of jobs. They communicate with partners and customers, gather requirements, plan, and then help in executing those plans. I'm not talking in details about this type of jobs in this video. Probably I'll create a separate video on this. Let's see, developer. These people convert the customer requirements or customer scenarios into real working code. That's why they must have good technical knowledge like coding, debugging, testing, writing technical designs, functional spec, deployment, and few more things. Depending on the company and the requirement, devs can be backend only dev, middle tier dev, front end dev, full stack dev, or DevOps. There are several types of dev jobs. So before applying them, make sure that it matches your qualification and interest. Next type of jobs are SDET or QA. These people test the code that developers write. There are multiple types of tests that needs to be conducted on the codes. For example, there can be functional testing, performance testing, regression testing, deployment testing, end-to-end testing, integration testing, and there are several other types of testings. So manual testing of the code is not viable for big companies. Hence, these people should also know how to automate the testing capabilities. Hence, they should have good technical and programming knowledge. Now, the next question is, do you need similar preparation for test and dev job? The quick answer is yes. Both of them deal with codes, hence both need good coding skill. But test jobs and then their interviews are relatively easier than the dev interview. And now, how to prepare for such type of technical interviews? As I said earlier, SDET and SDE, both they must have good technical and coding skills. You can generally learn any language of your choice. That can be C#, C++, Java, Python, or any other language. Requirements are not specific to any language, but you must have capability to solve problems. And you must be confident on whiteboarding, because big companies like Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, Google, they need candidates to solve problems in whiteboard or live coding interview. They'll give you a question and then you'll have to write code for that question in whiteboard in live session. And also keep in mind that solving the problem is not enough. Anybody can solve the problem, but solving the problem correctly and efficiently is what the interviewer looks for. Now, learning and practice materials. Generally, there are multiple places that you can start practicing. If you are not confident with coding, start learning them now. It's not too late. You can start with lead code for now, but keep in mind that questions may not be as is from lead code. There might be custom made questions as well, but lead code will give you enough information on what type of questions will be asked by the big companies. More importantly, do not try to memorize solution. Try solving them yourself. There are several IDEs available online. Some of them are given here as a reference, but they are just as a reference. You can use any IDEs of your choice. But my personal recommendation is, if you want to learn C# or .NET, I recommend using Visual Studio. Community edition of Visual Studio is free of cost. Go and download it now. Now, the question is, there are generally two types of jobs at big companies. One is full-time job, the second one is contract job. So now, which one is easier to pass the interview? Generally, vendor job interviews are easier than FT. Vendor job interviews are shorter, maybe one interview or two interview. And then if you do them good, you can pass it. But on the other hand, FT interviews are full day interviews, 5 to 6 interviews, and then you should pass all of them. What's the difference? FTs are company employees, like Microsoft employees. Vendors work on products and get all the resources from Microsoft, but they are not Microsoft employees. They report to their own company, they get salary from their own. You are given a question, you have a solution, what the interview looks for. Only the working solution is not enough. They also look at what approach do you take to solve the problem. Did you think about potential issues or bugs of your implementation ahead of time? Did you catch potential test cases? Can you think out of box? Maybe everybody knows the simplest solution, but Do you have the best solution? How do you behave in unclear requirements or difficult situations? In oftentimes, in real life, the requirements are not clear. The interviewer wants to know how do you handle those unclear requirements. And finally, and then most important, anytime if the interviewer feels that, okay, you are giving a memorized solution, then doesn't matter how good you are, you probably will fail the interview. So do not memorize any solution. Try to give your own solution. Now, here as a reference, I'm giving one simple example, how to solve one particular problem. Doesn't matter whether the question is simple or complex, but the interviewer wants to know how do you solve the problem. I'm giving here as an example, an array of integer is given, and then interviewer asks you to give a reverse of that array. Now, let's say I have four ways to solve this problem. All of them works perfect. All of them give the same result, and then all of the results are correct, but only one of them is perfect answer or considered good. Why? Let's see it in demo.